Good evening and peace be upon you. Today we have lecture 9 in this course, study skills. And we studied last lecture, in the last lecture, the end of the last lecture, the word STEM in the unit 3, the learning, the vocabulary or the vocabulary of English. And there are some exercises about the word STEM. Here is one of these exercises. Okay, they want from us here to write an example for each one of these STEM or the word STEM. For example, we have anthro. Okay, they give us the meaning of the of this STEM. Like anthro, it mean. The anthro mean a man or mankind, and here we have to put an example for this word STEM, like auto, our people, chrome, etc. The exercise, this exercise is long or very long, and we will read each word in it. Okay. This is I put here. Okay, this is 3 or 4 pages, and here the answers. The anthropology is an example for the anthro. Autobiography, the STEM is auto, okay, autobiography, and bibliography from the people, it means it has a meaning like book. Also, chromium, from chrome, it's the color. Chronograph, the meaning is the time. Okay, is from the steam chron. Here we reach to this word. Cosmopolitan, the STEM is cosm. The bicycle, the STEM is sickle, it is a wheel or circle. Dictate, to dict, the dict means say or speak. Update, also the STEM is duct, like the meaning of feed. Facsimile, to do something or to make, from the STEM fac. Formula, the meaning is form or shape, from the STEM form. Effort, also from fort, the meaning is strong. Okay, the second page here. I want someone from you to read these words. Just read the STEM and the meaning. Okay, Noor, you can read.
Geo, Earth, Geography. Gram, Graph, Write, Writing. Telegram, telegraph. Hetero, other, different. Heterogeneous. Homo, Sam, homograph. Logi, speech, word study. Analog, bipsychology. Man, menu, hand. Manasal, manufacture, matter, matri, mother, maternity,
maternity or
maternity,
matrimony,
matrimony, medi, middle, median, nomen, name, نوم and culture. Omni, all. Omnibus. Better, battery. Father, paternity, patrimony. Bathy, feeling, suffering. Bathetic.
Pathetic. Yes, you finish. Thank you.
Yes, doctor.
More. Yes.
You're welcome.
Can I read?
Okay. Just a minute. So the second table here. Yes, you can read. Feel
yes.
me like.
File. File. Like love. Bibliophile. Bibliophile. Phone. Sound. Phonology. Bird. Carry. Portfolio. Script. Script. Write. Scribble. Script, water, secure, port, carry, portfolio, script, script writer, script water, secure, follow, connect, soft, wisdom with sophistry, text, around order, taxonomy, tactical, tell, far, distant, telephone, timbre, time, temporary, Tech, tract, draw ball, tractor, wind, come, go, prevent, first, verse, turn, convert, adverse.
Convert or adverse, yes. It has, these words have the meaning for this area of meaning, okay, and they are from the word stem, these stems. Just maybe one table, the last one, folk, me call, advocate. Advocate, maybe شخص يدافع عن شيء معين, advocate. And folk, this word has a meaning for all or tearing, fulfill. Fulfill it mean turn or rule. Okay, this is about the word stem. We have here another exercise for they want here to circle the meaning for italicized word. The italicized word, this word, okay, this written in italicize and use your dictionary. They want to use the dictionary to write the original sentences or just to take the correct option for this. Anthropology is the study of animals or man or apes mean monkey, okay, and disease. The anthropology, yes. The answer is anthropology is the study for man or mankind, yes. Number four, they were deported. The meaning of deported, sent out of the country or carried to bed, dropped out of school, invited to come. What is the meaning of deported? Yes, anyone choose one of these options?
Sent out of the country.
Sent out of the country. Yes, this is the correct answer. Number five, bibliography. Bibliography for a course, literary, yes, there is a space here, requirement for outline, list of books, written assignments. Yes, tell me the meaning for bibliography.
Library doctor, requirement.
The library requirement, يعني متطلبات مكتبية, I think it is not the answer. You can try another one. Yes, you can check it in your dictionary.
List of books.
List of books. Yes, that's right. Okay, number six. Events told in chronological order. Chronological order. What's the meaning of this? Yes, Ahmad, you can speak directly without raising your hand.
Is it time?
Chronological, the meaning is a time. Yes, this is what is right. The events, الأحداث, told in chronological order, the meaning is a time. Here is the answers. This here.
Color one.
The meaning I point to this man, or here we have sent out of the country, list of books, time, as we solve it. Yes. Okay, guessing the meaning from context. Someone to read this part. Rama.
Yes.
There are three possible ways to learn the meaning of an unfamiliar word that you come across while reading. One, looking up the word in a dictionary. It should be used only if the following ways are not possible. Two, using what you know of word stems and word formations. Instead of looking up the words in a dictionary, you may try to analyze the new words and guess at their meaning. For example, incomprehensible. You properly know that comprehension means understanding. The able suffix forms an adjective, and the in prefix makes the word negative.
Yes, continue to these two lines.
Okay. Therefore, you can guess that incomprehensible probably means something like not understandable. However, this is limited and cannot be used with all words.
Okay, Ahmed, you can continue here. Yes, Ahmed Rida.
Looking carefully at the surrounding context, words have meaning in relation to other words and to the situations in which they are used. For example, there is no way to guess the meaning of haughty in, she was haughty. However, the sentence, she had a haughty manner, gives you a bit more information. You should now know that haughty refers to her personal behavior. Suppose in the sentence where her haughty manner of continually talking about herself irritated even her friends. You can guess that haughty must mean something like proud.
Okay, thank you, Ahmed. Just we'll go back to the beginning of this part, the guessing meaning from context. If you are reading something and maybe you will see some words you didn't know the meaning of these words, they are unfamiliar for you, unfamiliar words that you see it in any text. Okay, unfamiliar, you can't know the meaning of this word. It's غير مألوف. Okay, they said here that there's some possible ways or ways to learn the meaning. First one is known to you, that you can look up the word in the dictionary and you know the meaning of it. Okay, but maybe you can, or maybe sometimes it is unavailable to you using the dictionary, maybe, or in the exam or something like that. What can you do in these in this situation? First, here they put some options to use what you know of word stem. Okay, maybe you know the stem of the word and you can guess the meaning of the word. Like here, they give us an example for this long word, incomprehensible. Incomprehensible. What the meaning of this word? You can just to look at this word, comprehends or comprehension. The theme of this word is like that, comprehension. And you can see that able is a suffix, and in here, okay, is a prefix. The able, it means the adjective, or to turn the word to the adjective. And we see here that in can make the negative meaning for the word. Therefore, the comprehension itself, it means to understand or understanding. And incomprehensible, the meaning is negative here. It is when you can't understand something. Okay, like here they would not understandable, the meaning for incomprehensible. The second way, or the third way, if you want, to looking careful, looking at, or look at carefully to the surrounding context. Surrounding context, يعني سياق الموجود the text. Okay. Can you know the meaning for any word from the context? Yes, sometimes you can know the meaning. If you look at this example, the word, this word is naughty, not, sorry, haughty. The word haughty, haughty, what the meaning of haughty? If you see this word alone, okay, maybe you can't know the meaning. If you read, she was haughty, also you can't guess the meaning for this word. But if you add, or if I add the word manner for this sentence, she had a haughty manner. Okay, لديها, maybe haughty, you can't know the meaning of haughty, manner, اسلوب. Okay, then this is an, maybe you can guess that it is an adjective for a manner or behavior that she had. Okay, this is maybe will near the meaning. Near the meaning for you, or you can guess the meaning or guess the meaning for that. The haughty mean proud, like proud, يعني شخص متعجرف أو متغطرس أو فخور جدا. Okay, like proud. Her haughty manner of continually talking about herself irritated even her friends. Okay, if I put this word in a long sentence, maybe you can guess the meaning for that. Do you understand the meaning of what I said? Is it okay?
Yes, okay, Doctor. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
This word, haughty. Okay. This is the the transcription or the symbol for the word haughty, and this is the meaning here: unfriendly and seeming to consider herself better than other people. Okay, here we have an example for what I said. Here is an example for what I said. Look at this word, legend. Okay, the word legend. What the meaning of this word? If maybe you know the meaning of this word, I will tell you that the meaning of legend is, okay, an injury or wound. Also, it has a meaning like a bracelet, and this usually of made from gold, and also it means a headache. Okay, the legion, this word legion, it has three meaning: injury, الجرح مثلا, wound, and it has a meaning of bristle, الأسوارة, usually of gold, and headache, ألم في الرأس. There is three meaning for the word legion. Okay, if I said to you that she had a legion, what the meaning of this word legion? The meaning number one or two or three. Here we have to put improbable or possible or probable for each meaning here. Okay. Is it possible to meaning legion as an injury? She had an injury or a legion? Yes, it is possible. Okay. Then the second one. Is it possible that the meaning for legion is a bracelet? She had a bracelet. Yes, also it is possible. Is it possible for the third meaning? She had a headache. Also, it is possible, right? Then you can write here possible. And here you can write possible, ممكن يعني محتمل. And here it is possible also. Now, follow me to this sentence. He had a legion. I just want to add this on her arm, okay? For this sentence. Okay, also I put here the three meaning for legend, but we have to exclude, نستبعد, some of or one or two from these possible, okay, from these possible meaning. Now, the meaning for legend is an injury or a bracelet or headache. What can be here possible, or what is improbable? Improbable, that maybe the same meaning for impossible. Yani. يعني غير محتمل. هو كأنصار
An injury.
An injury
An injury or
possible.
wound possible. A a bracelet usually of gold possible. A headache impossible.
Yes, you are right. Headache, why this excluded? استبعدنا الهيدايك because they write here on her arm, right? And here
yes
the legion, كلمة legion mean الآفية أو الضرر in the head and here in the arm. Therefore we put here the word improbable. Okay, the third one, the third meaning I will maybe نجعل الشيء بشكل أضيق قليلا. The third one, who can read the third one and explain what happened when we add something? Yes, Haytham.
Yes, she had a lesion on her arm that would not stop bleeding.
Yes, this is a clue. This is something important here. Not bleeding. This will give us the meaning, right?
Yes.
An injury, it is possible.
Yes.
Yes, it is possible. And a bracelet, improbable. And headache.
And impossible.
Yes, impossible, or they give us this word, improbable, the same meaning, okay? Then we will
yes.
go to the answers here. Like we said, these two, three, these three is possible, and here we have possible, possible, improbable. They said here that probable, mean يعني مناسب, okay? They don't write. Here possible, okay, the same meaning, but here they are improbable because they give us more information and we know the context. We know here the context of this sentence. Yeah, هون عرفنا السياق بشكل أفضل لذلك عرفنا the meaning for this legion, okay? Now also the maybe the same. Well, not exactly the same exercise. We have a sentence here, and we will choose one of these options. Okay, who can try to read and answer this? Okay, I think Wasil.
The night was so that not a sound cloud be heard. Quite possible, beautiful possible, dark possible, dangerous impossible.
No, I don't want from you to put possible or impossible. Just choose one of these. One, just choose one. There is one option is correct
A.
and the others is incorrect.
A, quite.
Quite. What the meaning here? The night was so quiet. Yes, and that is no sound. Here they give the same meaning here. No sound could be heard, right? Okay, thank you, Wasil. Number three. Number three. Yes, who can read number three and give us the answer? Noor. Okay, Noor. No one raised your hand except Noor. Okay, you can read.
Although Amina expected her parents to be worried by her long and unexplained absence, both her mother and father seemed quiet and worried.
Okay, you are reading from the book, right?
Yes.
Okay, you can
I'm
look
sorry.
at that. You can
ما
look at
انتبهت ما انتبهت انا واحدة.
look at the screen and we choose the number 3. Yes, right here. You can read
اوكي
from the from your mobile. Yes.
اوكي his handwriting resulted from haste and carelessness rather than from the inability to form an ability to form the letters correctly.
Yes.
It's a beautiful handwriting.
Careful or unreadable, beautiful, silent.
Okay.
Maybe you didn't get the answer. His gab handwriting result from hast, sur'a, and carelessness. وعدم الاهتمام.
عدم الاهتمام.
Yes, what can we put here? الخط خط
Unreadable
جميل.
غير مقروءة.
Yes.
Unreadable غير مقروء.
His unreadable handwriting يعني خطه الغير مقروء هو نتيجة لإيش؟
لسرعته وقلة
Yes.
اهتمامه.
Yes, that's right. يس هيثم
بدك تبي يجاوب الجواب نفسه جوابته
يس از ان ابل تو فورم هي ميبي هي سيد راذر ذان فروم ذا ان ابيلتي تو فورم يعني عدم قدرته على ان يشكل ذا ليتر كوركتلي ميبي اي ويل ستوب هير تو جاست تو اوبن اندر Okay, now we will continue in the second session from this lecture. We solve it here, quiet, and here we choose unreadable. Now we have another exercise here. You have to use or you have to see the contextual clues. Contextual clues, يعني السياق, to guess the meaning of the italicized word. To the italicized word, like here, trivet. Okay, look at the at this word trivet without reading. Okay, don't read the sentence. Look also only to this word trivet. Maybe it is strange or unfamiliar for you. Okay, you can't know the meaning for this word. But when you read the sentence, okay, maybe you can guess the meaning from the context, from the context. I will read the first one. In order not to burn a table, in order not to burn, يحرق a table, he put a trivet under the hot dish. Under the hot dish, okay? Maybe you can guess the or you can thought in the meaning here about something putting under the hot dish, okay? You can me or you can know the meaning here from this context, right? Okay, here the meaning of trivet. Is anything putting under the something hot to prevent ليمنع to burn the table or burn the floor. Okay. Now the second word swerved. Swerved. You look at the swerved. Maybe you can't know the meaning of this word, but if you read. This sentence here, maybe you can get the meaning. Who can try to find the meaning of this word? Rama.
The driver swerved her car to miss the little girl in the road.
To miss
maybe
the little girl in the road, yes. Here we have a driver and maybe drove a car, right? And
yes.
He maybe he saw a little girl in front of him, and what he did? He swerved. What's the meaning?
It's verb. I think maybe he turned left or right.
Yes. Yes, very good. He turned the car on the left or on the right. That is correct. Thank you, Ralph. Number four, here another example. If you look at the language, you don't know the meaning of the word language. Okay, but if you read this sentence, maybe you can guess the meaning. Okay, who can try? Try to read and find the meaning from the context. The illness left the woman so languid that she, yes, Rua?
Yes. The illness left the woman so languid that she couldn't even cross the room for a glass of water. Languid, I think it means not able or so tired.
So tired, weak person, ضعيف جدا, right? And he can't, maybe can't move or can't walk to take a glass of water. From the kitchen, maybe, right? Thank you, Rod. Right. I will put here the answers. Okay. Should we have to read this, or it is clear? Okay. I will read it for someone, or I want someone to read the. Three sentences here. Just reading. You have a lot of time. Rua, also Rua. Okay, Rua.
Yes. In order not to burn the table, he put a trivel under the hot dish. A trivel, a metal support used to hold a hot dish.
Metal, Number metal two, support. Metal, معدني. Yes.
Number two, the driver swerved her car to miss the little girl in the road. Swerved, it means to make a sudden sideways movement while moving forwards, usually in order to avoid hitting someone or something.
Yes.
Number four, the illness left the woman so languid that she couldn't even cross the room for a glass of water. Languid, it means moving slowly and involving very little energy.
Okay, يعني ما عنده طاقة, energy, and move slowly. Yes. محمود, right, peace be upon you. عليكم السلام. Here, this three words that we talk, swerve, to change direction, and this languid, to move or speak slowly with a little energy, and trivet, this is trivet, you see it, putting under something hot, maybe, yes. I think it is the end. of the session or the lecture. Now, if you have any question, you can ask. Okay, this maybe 22 slide. They are speak about the stem of the word and the meaning from the context, and how can you get the meaning if you don't know the meaning of this word from the context or from the stem of the word. This is all for today. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening.